Hey everyone, it's Paul from Balance Your Life and welcome to the dark side of the munchies. Today we're tackling a mind-bending topic, weed and psychosis. Buckle up, because this roller coaster of science, brain chemistry, and mental health is about to get wild. First things first, is weed the ultimate psychovillain? Not quite. Research suggests it's more like a sneaky accomplice, increasing the risk of psychosis, but rarely acting alone. Think of it like this: imagine your brain is a rickety bridge over a stormy ocean. Some people inherit wobbly planks, making them more likely to fall if a freak wave, stress, trauma, hits. Weed, in this case, is like a strong gust of wind. For some, it can topple you off, but for others, it's just a harmless breeze. But how does weed even mess with your mind? The culprit is THC, the main psychoactive ingredient. It floods your brain with dopamine, the feel-good chemical, creating that happy high. But in some people, especially young brains still under construction, THC can overstay its welcome and start messing with the delicate dance of neurotransmitters. This can lead to psychosis, a break from reality with symptoms like delusions, believing fake things, hallucinations, seeing or hearing things that aren't there, and disorganized thinking, feeling like your thoughts are tangled in a barbed wire fence. So, what are the red flags? If you or someone you know is smoking weed and experiencing any of these, it's time to call a mental health professional. Hearing voices or seeing things that others don't. Feeling suspicious and paranoid, like everyone is against you. Having strange beliefs that others think are weird, like aliens are reading your mind. Losing touch with reality, feeling like you're in a dream or movie. Remember, psychosis is serious, but it's treatable. The sooner you seek help, the better the chance of getting back on track. Now, before we light up the conclusion, let's address the elephant in the room: risk percentages. Unfortunately, science hasn't pinned down the exact number of THC-induced psychosis cases. It's like trying to count raindrops in a hurricane. There are too many factors at play. But what we do know is that early and heavy weed use, especially in young brains, significantly increases the risk. So, if you're young and thinking about lighting up, consider this: is a temporary high worth the potential price of messing with your mind for good? The bottom line: weed and psychosis have a complex, not fully understood relationship. It's not a guaranteed one-way ticket to crazy town, but it can be a risky trip for some. So, stay informed, be cautious, and if in doubt, seek help. Your brain will thank you. And that's the scoop on weed, psychosis, and the tricky brain. Remember to like, subscribe, and leave a comment below if you have any questions or mind-blowing facts to share. Until next time, stay safe and keep your neurons firing in the right direction. See you soon.